A single prisoner altered the fate of hundreds. But he paid a high price for it. Sleeper destroyed the barrier. But while all the other prisoners escaped, he remained behind in the rubble. It was I who dispatched him against the sleeper. Now it is I who brings him back from there. He is weak and has forgotten much. But he is alive. He's back.
There you are again. I never thought the two of us would meet again.
I feel like I spent 3 weeks lying under a load of rocks.
Well, so you did. Only the magic within your armor kept you alive. I had feared I might not be able to rescue you from the debris of the temple. But enough of that. You're here now. There's a new threat that we have to deal with.
After the fall of the barrier and the banishment of the sleeper, Beliar's wrath has grown even greater. A mighty artifact, so it is written in the old scriptures, will be brought back to this world when the God of Darkness sends his henchmen out to search. This search has long since begun. Beliar's henchmen are desecrating the oldest shrines of the gods. The guardians of these holy places have awakened, and their wrath makes the earth tremble. Every powerful magician on this island could sense this wrath. And some of them have certainly begun to face the threat. We do not have much time left.
What can we do?
This time we cannot handle it by ourselves.
You must become their ally. That's the only way to stop Beliar.
I'll be on my way as fast as I can.
Good. And one more thing. Don't tell anyone that you've talked to me. Above all, don't tell any magician. Since I have gone into exile, the Circle of Fire has taken me for dead, and that's a good thing.
Thank you. is that you? Really? Man, am I glad to see you.
Lester, how did you get here?
That was a crazy escape. After the barrier exploded, I wandered around the area for a while in total confusion. Then I spent days fighting my way through these woods until I finally found this valley here. Diego, Milton, and Gorn are still in the Valley of Mines. At least, I think so.
I'm on my way to Khorinis. What do you know about the town?
Really? They won't even let you into the town.
Do you have any suggestions how I could get into town?
I certainly do. I worked for an old alchemist named Constantino some time ago. He has great influence in the city, and he's instructed the guards at the gate to let anyone through who can sell him rare herbs. So it's quite easy, really. You collect a large bunch of the plants that grow here all over the place, and then you pretend you're working for Constantino, and in you go.
Thanks for the hint. What do you know about the area?
If you keep going down that way, you'll come to a farm. The city starts a little way beyond that.
Why are you hanging around on my land? Whose side are you on? The rebelling farmers or the king?
I don't understand.
Don't you know what's going on? Boy, where are you from? We're on the edge of a civil war. Up till now, all the farmers looked at the tribute to the city as fair taxation. But since the paladins have come to Khorinis, the city guards visit us more and more often. And little by little, they're taking everything. If it goes on like this, soon we won't have anything left for ourselves. Some farmers are starting to rebel. Onar was the first of them. Onar is the biggest farmer here in the area. He is broken with the city. They say he's hired mercenaries to keep the city guard off his back. I don't know much about the guys. Supposedly, a lot of them are former prisoners from the mining colony. Everybody knows what you can expect from them.
One less monster around.
Psst. Hey, you, come here.
What is it?
On your way to the city, and really busy, too. Listen, you look like a smart guy to me. I bet you'll go far in life. You're certainly nobody's fool. I could see that right away. Say, you'd probably like to earn a few gold coins, wouldn't you?
Why not?
You'll have to forgive an ignorant old seaman. I'm a stranger in these parts, and I don't really know all the rules. So I had to find out the hard way that traveling strangers aren't welcome in the harbor city. Now I'm standing here with no idea how I'm supposed to get into the city. I have some extremely important business to conduct, and my client won't tolerate a delay, you see. You'll help me find a way to get past the city guard, won't you?
I'll have to think about it first.
All right, but hurry up about it. I've got no time to lose.
They should let you pass if you're wearing these farmer's clothes.
That's just what I need. Man, I knew I could count on you. Nobody will bother me disguised as a local yokel. Excellent. You did really well. Here's your promised reward.
What? 50 measly gold coins? You can't be serious.
Gold isn't everything, my friend. Take them for now. I have the feeling that we'll be seeing one another soon. And who knows, maybe I'll return the favor. Look after yourself.
Halt!
What is it?
You aren't getting in here, my boy.
Why not?
Looking the way you do, you're sure to cause nothing but trouble here, boy. We got enough rabble in the city. We have no use for people without money.
I'm bringing some herbs for Constantino, the alchemist.
Really? Then you won't mind showing me what you brought. Looks good. All right, in you go. but don't cause any trouble. Understood?
But the human and the beast waged war upon the land of Adonis, and the wrath of the gods was with them.
Halt, stranger. I am Lothar, paladin of the king and humble servant of Innos, your lord.
Since people have started simply vanishing all over this town, everyone needs to watch out that they don't suffer the same fate.
The townspeople are simply disappearing?
Yes, it seems to be more every day. It's most annoying that the militia have still not been able to discover what's behind these strange occurrences. Small wonder that the town's inhabitants are very wary of strangers right now. So don't provoke them when you're in town. Understood?
I've got to go. As long as you're in Khorinis, you can feel safe. The king's paladins watch over this city now.
Adonis be with you.
Who are you?
I am Vatras, a servant of Adonis, the guardian of the divine and earthly equilibrium. But I know nothing about you at all.
What do you want to know?
Well, you could tell me where you come from and why you have come to the city.
Terrible things are bound to happen soon.
Terrible things, hmm? How do you know this?
Zardas, the magician, told me. He sent me to warn the paladins.
The necromancer? So he lives, and he sent you. Who are you really?
I'm a former convict from the penal colony of Khorinis.
Good. That all sounds rather fantastic, but I cannot perceive that you are lying to me. Therefore, I must assume that your motives are honorable.
What exactly is it that you do?
They are exploring the ruins of an old culture northeast of Khorinis. We suspect that those ruins might contain a passage to a part of the island which is as yet uncharted. Khorinis is facing a great enigma these days. The number of people missing from the town seems to increase almost daily. I consider it a matter of utmost importance.
What do you know about the disappearances of the citizens of Khorinis?
What happened the other day was really quite strange. There was this fellow who came here. hours.
I think his name is Joe.
Works all day too.
He bragged that he would soon come into some serious money. He claimed that he knew how to get into one of the city towers where the militia keep their arms. I haven't seen him since, even though I used to bump into him around the same time every day. I reported this to the militia. I thought that maybe he had been caught and thrown into the dungeon. But Lord Andre had no idea what I was talking about. He didn't even know the fella.
So, where is your friend Trokar now?
Only a few days ago, we were both standing at the bar in Korrigan's tavern, discussing the hunt. Don't ask me what happened next. I had had a few by then. I vaguely remember Trokar saying that he was going out to get a few swamp weed reefers. He never came back.
Where does one get swamp weed reefers?
Somewhere down at the harbor, as far as I know.
Hey, I don't know you. What do you want here? Are you headed for the tavern?
No, I'm not headed for the tavern.
Yeah, that's what I would have said. But that isn't important, and that's why we can get straight down to business. Since you're new here, I'll make you an offer. You give me 50 gold pieces and you can go. That's your entrance fee for the tavern.
Forget it. You won't get a single coin.
Then I'll take everything you have. As soon as you're lying on the ground in front of me.
That was obvious all along.
Finish him!
These are bad times.
I'm no better off myself.
That's what I always say.
You have enough
money. He had better shot.
Nobody will learn.
Hey, you! Where you going? No matter what your plans are, there'll be plenty of time later. You're right in front of the Pearl of Khorinis, the Red Lantern. This is the most beautiful brothel in all of Myrtana, damn it. Sailors from the most remote corners of the world dock here just to spend a few nights in the Red Lantern. Now, it's you who has the chance, nay, the honor of spending a night with Nadia, the most passionate flower of the gods.
I am Bromo, this is my house, and these are my girls. I like my girls. And if you like my girls too, then you'll pay for it, 50 gold pieces.
Are all your girls accounted for?
Of course they are. Or do you think I want to go to jail over something like that?
I wasn't asking about your payroll. I mean, are they all present, or have any gone missing?
Oh, yeah. Actually, one of my girls has up and left. Her name's Lucia. I reported it to the militia, too, but they claim they haven't found a trace of her yet.
Bromar doesn't like to see us talk to guests during work if there's nothing in it for him. So you want to know more about the people who disappeared down here at the harbor, do you? I don't know whether I can help you much, but at least I can tell you what became of Lucia.
Tell me about Lucia.
Nobody here is too sorry that she's gone.
Why?
I don't think there was anyone here whom she didn't try to use. She was a real bitch. She used to see a lot of Elverich, the apprentice of Thorben, the carpenter from the lower part of town. I bet she's up and left with that young man.
Where could the two of them have gone?
If the wolves didn't eat them, I suppose they went to stay with the farmers. Where else would they go?
What else do you know?
I've heard many stories about people who disappear down here at the harbor, but I'm not so sure whether I should believe them.
Don't tell this to anyone.
You should have a chat with the merchants down here. That's all I can tell you, alas. Now, what about the two of us, sweetie? Wouldn't you like to have a little fun before you leave?
Got to go now.
Too bad. Well, come back to me the next time.
His name is Monty. He's vanished into thin air.
It's a bad business.
Farum, the fisherman, told me something similar. His buddy William is no longer around. I bet that the orcs are behind all this.
So he has. He's a fisherman, but a little too big for his boots, I should add.
He should have stayed well away from that bunch.
What bastards would those be?
I don't know who they are or what their business is here in Khorinis. I only know the place where they met up with William. There's a bay opposite the harbor, north of here. You can only reach it by boat or swim. There's a beach there and a small fishing camp. That's where I saw them. I just happened to see William there when I was fishing in the bay.
There you are at last. I've been waiting here for hours. Just a moment. You're not a merchant from town, are you?
Who are you?
I don't see how that's any of your business. But if you must know, my name is Skip. Does that ring a bell?
Who?
Are you telling me you've never heard of Skip? Holy shit! Where do you live? I'm one of Khorinis's most wanted criminals. Me and my boys have been the scourge of the waters around this crummy island for years.
A lot of citizens are missing, and everything seems to indicate that you're not quite innocent in the matter.
Damn it. It's not what you think it is. Do I look like a slave trader to you? No, I only transport goods. What they are and where they come from is no concern of mine. We have shipped all kinds of things for those swine. First, it was just regular stuff. Well, sometimes it may have been contraband. But then they started to kidnap the inhabitants of the city. No idea what they're planning to do with them.
Who are you talking about?
The bandits, of course. Who else? Filthy scum, who are making themselves at home all over the island.
Just bandits isn't good enough for me. I want a name.
A name? You want to know who's leading the bandits? Damn it! What was that bastard's name again? I just can't recall his name. Even if it wasn't all that complicated. But I can show you where to find the boss of the gang in this part of Khorinis. There's a very big farm far to the east. The farmer's name is Onar, I think. He's got some fairly large fields. To the south of those fields, there's a small fortress on a high cliff. That's where you'll find your man. I remember his name now. Dexter. Yes, I think they called him Dexter.
Hey, thanks, man. I mean, thank you, really. And there I was, thinking I'd never get out of here. I got locked in. The door was open, and all I wanted to do was have a little look-see. But as soon as I was inside, the guard came and locked the damn door. This is, somewhat embarrassing. I'd be very grateful if it could just remain between you and me.
Look who's just turned up. The farmer boy. You're just in time.
Are you still having problems with the city guards?
I'll give you problems, you punk. I need weapons, I need provisions, and gold wouldn't be bad either.
Here's 10 gold coins.
You poor sucker. You can keep your dough. I have a better idea. I've been around here before, and I buried my stuff in a few places. I want you to help me with it. Not too bad for a landlubber.
Anything else?
Yeah, you big mouth. Is there something else? I'm looking for a fellow. He isn't anywhere to be found in the city, and these losers here don't have a clue either. He's thin, dark-haired, and he usually wears red armor. As far as I know, he used to be a prisoner in the colony. I think his name starts with a D.
I take it you're looking for someone named Dexter?
Damn it, how would I know the fellow's name?
I know where you can find him.
Really? Tell me.
Not far from here. He seems to be the leader of an evil gang of bandits.
Ha! Yup. That's him. I knew the old landlubber'd hold up here somewhere. Now, all I need to do is scour all the hideouts and rat holes around here.
Maybe we should go and see him together.
All right, friend. Go and find him.
What about you, then?
Someone has to guard our backs. And now, in you go. Halt! You can't go through here.
I want to talk to your leader.
But only if you know his name. Because if you don't, I'll be obliged to kill you. Well?
Dexter.
Well, I guess you know the boss. Okay, I'll let you through. But I'm warning you. You get too close to anybody, you won't get out of here alive. So take a deep breath and leave your weapons where they are. You'll find Dexter in the house.
That'll never change.
Hey, you!
Look who's here, the great emancipator. Well, hero, what are you doing here?
I'm looking for a few answers.
I never thought you'd come here voluntarily.
What do you mean by that?
I mean that I've been looking for you. Haven't you seen any of my wanted posters? They all bear your mug. Oh yes, you're very much wanted. Didn't you know that?
So, what do you want from me?
Me? Nothing whatsoever. But my boss is hell-bent on seeing you dead. So he wants me to find you and bring him your head.
They say that you're kidnapping people from Khorinis.
So you found that out too. Good work, Buster. And here I was thinking I had covered my tracks.
Where did those people disappear to? Maybe down the mines somewhere here?
They're far away in the northeast by now, where you can't get to them. I could show you where exactly, but I don't know why I would want to do that.
Who gave you this order?
My boss. He's a dangerous man. You know him. Raven, one of the former ore barons from the old camp in the Valley of Mines. He needs those people to fulfill his plans, and that's all you need to know.
Raven? Dangerous? Oh, well.
What do you know? You don't know him like I do. He was a miserable swine even back then. But these days, he has changed since the fall of the barrier. There's a black shadow across his face. His fierce glance will pierce you like the claws of a raptor, if you look into his eyes for too long.
And what do you intend to do now? Kill me?
Yeah.
Dexter bought it, right?
Looks like he's dead.
None too soon either. Go check out what he's got on him.
Dexter carried nothing but this letter.
Show me that thing. Ah, oh, damn it, that doesn't help me at all. So I'm stranded here. Dexter was my last hope.
What did you want from Dexter?
I've come from beyond the mountains in the northeast of this island, and I want to go back. I had hoped that the bastard would know how to get there without a ship.
I saw a pirate named Skip near the port.
That moron. I waited there for 3 days, so why is he coming so late? Once I get my strength back, I'll give him what for.
What is there beyond those mountains?
You had better not try to go there. Those are rough lands. A wimp like you wouldn't last long.
About those missing people?
Yes?
I know where the missing people are.
What have you found out?
A man named Raven dragged them off to a remote part of Khorinis.
What makes you so sure?
I read his orders. He's got the local bandits working for him. Here.
Good. You did a great job. I had feared that we might have to resign ourselves to never knowing. I shall send you through the portal together with the other water mages. You are to track down the former ore baron Raven and find out why he has taken the citizens of Khorinis. We here shall continue to try and deal with the threat posed by the bandits. Bring this letter to Satyrus. He will set your tasks from now on. Go down to the harbor. You'll find a man there named Laris. Give him this ornament and tell him that it needs to be returned. He'll know what to do with it.
I must be crazy. What are you doing here?
Hey, Laris, you old scoundrel. How did you get here?
I was able to escape to the Valley of Mines just in time, together with Lee and some of the other boys. He and his boys are now on the farm of Onar, the landowner. He made a deal with the farmer. He and his boys defend the farm, and Onar feeds them in return.
Vatras gave me this ornament to bring to you. He said it is to be taken back.
Of course. It's up to me, as usual. I might have known. I'll have to walk halfway across the island to take it back to the water mages.
Let us take Vatras' ornament back.
Then let's go. Follow me. Now that we're no longer in town and cannot be overheard, let me tell you a little more. We are now going to take this ornament that you brought me back to Satyrus. We lads from the former new camp still have good relations with the water mages. Even Lee will still protect the water mages against any danger today if it's within his power. To keep up the contact with the water mages, I'm in town most of the time, working together with Vatras. And this is the armor that is issued to each of us by the water mages. The water mages are all beside themselves. They've been digging at an excavation site in the northeast for weeks. It's anybody's guess what they're trying to find there. It all started when the earth began trembling like it did in the worst times of the barrier. Horrible stone creatures emerged from the ground, slaying everyone who went within 100 feet of them. The water mages took the matter in hand and destroyed those hostile invaders. And now they're digging down there, searching for an explanation for these strange events. But you will soon see for yourself. We're here. Take the ornament. The water mages must be in there somewhere. Take it to them. If you should meet any beast down in that hole in the ground that look like they're too much for you, flee forward to Satyrus. He'll take care of the beast for you. I need to go back. And one more thing. Don't even think about strolling around for long with this ornament. Go directly to Satyrus. See you.
Thank you.
Are you mad? Get out of here. It's too dangerous in these vaults for a would-be adventurer. But say, don't I know you? Of course, you bastard. Don't think that I could have forgotten how you betrayed us in the new camp. You drained our mound of ore of all magic power, and then simply disappeared. What exactly did you think you were doing?
It was necessary. Without the power of the ore, I could never have defeated the Sleeper.
What sort of drivel is that? Sleeper? Defeated? Do you have the slightest idea what you have done? You have confused the structure of magic so much that it could be heard back in Khorinis. Count yourself lucky that the barrier simply collapsed one day.
What are you complaining about? It all worked out all right.
Mind your tongue! What the blazes do you want here anyway?
I brought your ornament.
What in all the world is that supposed to mean? Who gave you that?
Come off it now. I brought it to you. You do want it, don't you?
Certainly, but it disturbs me that you have your hand in the game once again.
Why are you making such a big deal about that old business with the ore mound? After all, you can't say that I was unreliable.
And what did it ultimately get me? Just don't think that I trust you.
What are you doing down here?
These halls conceal ancient secrets, mysterious secrets. The inscriptions and murals indicate a very ancient culture. Everything you can see here is written in a language completely unknown to us. We are only just beginning to learn it and grasp its meaning.
Why is this ornament so important to you?
It is the key to a portal. I shall not tell you more.
I brought a part of the ornament.
Yes? Oh, that's terrific. Now I have them all. Now all we have to do is put them together. We will have to use our combined powers to fit the piece back into a ring. Follow me. There. And now, step aside. The ornament has been put back together. Go to Satyrus and let him give you the reassembled ring. Hopefully, the portal will then open.
Good. However, I'm still waiting for a message from Vatras. Until I receive it, we cannot go.
I have a message from Vatras for you.
Very interesting. All right, here, take the ring. We shall gather at the portal and wait for you.